General Daniel Morgan, a man who needs little introduction. He was a tough Pennsylvania woodsman and wagoner. He was regarded in his lifetime as being tough as nails. He was the hero of two of the major turning points during the American War for Independence. He was also present at the Battle of Quebec and Braddock's expedition during the French and Indian War. Despite spending most of his life as rebellious and a tough brawler, the story of his eventual salvation is one that must be spread. Little is known about Daniel Morgan's early life, but most of what is known began with his teenage years. As a young teenager, he got into an argument with his father and ran away from home. He was well capable of taking care of himself. He stood at 6 foot, a height that, back in colonial times, was considered very tall. He was very burly, strong, and muscular. He ventured out into the frontiers of Virginia, Kentucky, and Tennessee, going from job to job, eventually finding an occupation as a wagoner. During this time, he found himself caught up with the wrong crowd. He frequented local bars, he drank, and was a noted gambler. He also became renowned in the area as a brawler. He took on other men with all that he had, winning most of his battles. He got himself into a lot of trouble, but he always managed to fight his way out. His personality continued to develop as he became tougher, wilder, and much more undisciplined. When he was in his late teens and early 20s, the French and Indian War took place. This war was fought between the French, who had most of the Native Americans as allies, and Great Britain, who had most of the American colonists as allies. Being a wagoner, Daniel Morgan, along with his fellow frontiersman and first cousin Daniel Boone, offered up the services of himself and his wagon to General Edward Braddock, the British leader, in his campaign against the French and the natives. At this time, young Dan was still very rebellious and still had some of the same personality issues that caused him to clash with his father. A British officer noticed Morgan's extremely independent behavior. Annoyed, the officer knocked young Morgan over the head with his sword. In defense, Morgan planted one good punch into the British officer, knocking him out instantly. After the campaign, Morgan was punished by the British with 500 lashes. This punishment was one that was given for the worst of crimes and would have killed an ordinary man. He survived the lashes, and even though he lived and survived physically, hatred and bitterness towards the British began to develop in his young heart as he grew into a man. Morgan spent the rest of the French and Indian War away from the British. Instead, he headed out further west and gave the natives a taste of their own medicine. He carefully studied their tactics, tendencies, and methods, and returned home after the war as an underappreciated, abused hero. After this, Morgan lived a much quieter life than he had before. He began a romantic relationship with a young girl named Abigail, with the two legally married in 1773. During these quiet years of his life, he transitioned from an independent and undisciplined teenager to an independent and undisciplined adult. By the time the American War for Independence began, Morgan was almost 40, and he was probably one of the most experienced fighters, brawlers, and riflemen that the Continental Army could enlist the support of. Of course, Morgan still had a score to settle with the British, so he willingly and gladly joined the Continental Army. During the war, Morgan would play a key role in the Revolution's two major turning points. At the Battle of Saratoga, he led his troops and helped win the famous battle that would go on to convince the nation of France to support America during their war. At the Battle of Cowpens 4 years later, he was the American commander of the battle and came up with a tactic that brought the British to their knees. The Battle of Cowpens would lead to the Battle of Yorktown, where General Lord Charles Cornwallis, the British commander of the Southern Campaign, surrendered to General George Washington, bringing the fighting in the American Revolution to an end. During the war, Daniel Morgan began to turn to God. Many times he had faced death. Some thought Morgan was a fearless man, but in truth he understood that death could be just around the corner. Before the Battle of Quebec, Morgan said a brief prayer. It is unknown if this was his first prayer or not. This prayer certainly seemed to have been the one that saved his life. During the Battle of Quebec, Morga's superior, Major General Richard Montgomery, was killed. Morga's other superior, Colonel Benedict Arnold, was wounded in action. Daniel Morgan, on the other hand, survived the battle without a scratch. He would later attribute this to his pre-battle prayer. Before the Battle of Cowpens, Daniel Morgan had gone to prayer again. He knew that there were only two outcomes for the battle: a major win for the Patriots or a major win for the British Army. Perhaps because of his prayer, the battle turned out to be a major win for his side. Later in life, Daniel Morgan was drawn to Reverend William Hill, who in turn led him to the Lord in 1801. After this point, Morgan, the man who was once rebellious and independent, became an outspoken advocate for Jesus Christ. He declared that the only way of salvation was through Jesus. He also spoke out against the beliefs of Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, and Thomas Paine, who all thought that God did not involve himself with the affairs of men. Morgan, perhaps from personal experience, knew that God did care about men and that God cared about him. After having lived only a year in the Lord, Morgan died in 1802 with a preacher by his side, who wanted to make sure that Morgan was really ready to meet Jesus. Many know Morgan as history depicts him, a tough, brave, bold, smart man. While this depiction is true, few have given proper credit to the source of Morgan's success. Morgan wasn't just a hero because of his battle plans, tactics, skills, but he was great because he looked to the Lord and later even came to know the Lord as his personal Savior. No matter how rebellious you've been, you can still come to the Lord. If he accepted wild Daniel Morgan, he will accept you. He loves you, and he will make you the winner, just as he did to Daniel Morgan. Let him fight your battles, and you will always be on the winning side. If you enjoy this video, I encourage you to check out the YouTube series His Story, Christ in America, which deals with the faith of Morgan's contemporaries and predecessors. January 17, 2017 will mark the 236th anniversary of the Battle of Cowpens, Daniel Morgan's greatest military victory.